Ladies and gentlemen, it's the spooky month, which means it's a perfect time to dive into everything scary. Most people like to talk about their favorite horror movies or games around this time of year, and I'm actually no different. Demons, skeletons, and vampires are all spooky, but you know what's even scarier?
MKLeo.
This is Leonardo Lopez Perez. He's a Mexican Smash player who's been hailed pretty much as a prodigy since day one. He won his first tournament when he was 8 in 2009, but his identity as the prodigy wouldn't really come around until his rise in Smash 4. At the age of 14, Leo would be known as the best player in his country almost overnight after stomping Mr. R in Smash Factor 4. And by the end of 2016, Leo would rise to the level of top 10 in the world, and only half a year later after that, Leo would be recognized as the second best player in the world. However, Leo eventually reached a Chilean-sized roadblock. While Leo was undeniably good, he never really dethroned the king. But when Zero eventually retired, it was time for MKLeo to inherit the title of the Prince of Smash 4. When the all-time rankings of Smash for Wii U were released, MKLeo was placed at third. And while this ranking may have been less than what he had hoped for, Leo's attention soon turned to Smash Ultimate. Zero's reign over Smash 4 and his 56 win streak was impressive, but Leo's consistent dominance from the grave of Loser's Bracket has continued since the game has launched. MKLeo is undeniably the best player Ultimate has ever seen, but if he's so dominant, what's the point of this video? Well, we have our protagonist, so let's look at our setting. Frostbite 2020 was a major held in Detroit, Michigan on February 21st, and for a tournament less than half the size of EVO, it was pretty stacked. Frostbite was a winter regional tournament started in 2016, so the venue was a familiar stomping ground for many of the top players. Coincidentally, Frostbite ended up being the last major before the COVID lockdown, so this tournament would be the last hurrah for this age of Smash, especially before the allegations in June of 2020. So what made Frostbite so important?
Not getting anything off of these gun attempts too. I mean, I like the downward angle guns, but that's just
ain't
it.
Oh,
what?
Oh, no.
Are you kidding?
No.
Oh. Prodigy.
Kurama upsets Leo 3-0 in a set that was barely 10 minutes long. Kurama wasn't even ranked within the top 50 of the world. The year prior at EVO 2019, Leo was sent into the loser's bracket and top 32 before he brought it all the way back to win grand finals. Leo just got sent to the loser's bracket in round 1 of top 96. The Prince of Smash 4 now faced the gauntlet of some of Ultimate's greatest talents, and in order to win the tournament, he would have to fight through 9 consecutive sets just to get to Grand Finals, or he would have to play 2 more sets to win. A single set loss would eliminate him from the tournament. On February 23rd, 2020, MKLeo would do the impossible. 11 sets, 10 players, 1 day left of Frostbite, 1 Joker. King Chris was the first on the chopping block. Chris was a ZSS main, and unfortunately for him, Leo kinda has a lot of matchup experience here. This is actually the only match of the run that wasn't livestreamed, but homie got 3-0'd, so lucky for him that it wasn't recorded. Evil X number 2 is a familiar face, it's Salem. As a former EVO champ and Smash 4 Bayo main, he's an asshole in-game and in real life, so it's kinda fitting that he ended up maining the meme machine in Ultimate. After narrowly taking game 1, Leo gets a 2-1 lead and forces Salem to switch.
Matrix today, good job. Actually stall for a little bit.
Bad call. Top 24 round 1, Dark Wizzy, the best Mario player in the world. 3-0. Kurama also just got eliminated by Matty G, so he's already outplaced the player who sent him back into losers. Next player, Sam Sora, best Peach in the world, generally kind of a douchebag, and ranked number 2 worldwide. 2 stalked. Twice. 3-0. Leo's match to get into top 8 will be against Nairo, ranked 4th in the world and the best Palu in the world.
Sorry, Louis.
Nairo was the second best player in Smash 4's all-time PGR, placing right above Leo. However, it's been a long time since 2018 and Leo's hungry for a spot in top 8. First match ends in a 2-stock from Leo, and while Nairo squeaks out game 2, Leo finishes the set with a commanding 3-1 victory. Leo's first obstacle of top 8 would be the Beast from the East, Japanese MKLeo. We've reached the final stretch of the bracket, which means the players are only gonna get tougher and the rivalries are only gonna become more fierce. So Zachary has a bit of history with MKLeo. At EVO 2019, Leo and Zachary had a nail-biter set that Zachary would end up losing. At this point, Zachary had major wins against nearly every top player aside from Leo, which made this loss hurt even more. A week later, Zachary would get a chance at a run back with SmashCon 2019, which unfortunately would end with another emotional loss for Zachary. Frostbite was Zachary's chance to slay the beast once and for all, and put Leo's loser's bracket run to rest. After taking a 2-1 lead, most would think Zachary was posed to win. However, Zach was face to face with the most terrifying face in Smash, Game 4 Leo. MKLeo has an almost paranormal ability to clutch out any set he finds himself losing. Statistically speaking, Leo alone is statistically more likely to win a set when down 2-0, which is unheard of in basically any esport. Leo's unnatural ability to kick it into a higher gear halfway through a set created the myth of Game 4 Leo, where he became virtually unstoppable. Even after Frostbite, Leo maintains this reverse 3-0 streak to this day. Regardless, having a positive win percentage when faced with game point is a scary track record, and Zachary was about to be turned into a statistic. After another nail-biter game 4, a convenient whiff from Zachary's up air, Leo pops off and wins the set. Burst the poor kid's heart in the process. Just look at him, dude. He's about to burst into tears. The man of my dreams, DeBuzz, would also fall to Leo 3-0. Unfortunately for him, he had an 0-12 record against Leo prior to just a few weeks ago, so this one was just not in the cards. Loser Semis, one of Japan's strongest players and by far the best Pac-Man in the world, it's T. He brings Leo to Game 4 at 2-1, which, yeah, Game 5. Leo pops off and takes the set, but let's rewind that last stock real quick. T's F smash was a single frame away from connecting with Leo to steal the set. A nearly frame perfect shield like this is really just luck more than anything, but for Leo, this is par for the course. Just like Leo's comeback statistic, most people are convinced that Leo has some sort of plot armor allowing him to escape from impossible situations. Similarly, MKLeo was frames away from losing Game 4 against Zachary, who was just barely short of a full up air. Most people chalk Game 4 Leo up to him being cracked, but there's really no explanation for why Lady Luck seems to favor Leo so much. Losers Finals. Only one more set until Leo gets his ticket into Grand Finals. 2019's Frostbite Champ and EVO Runner-Up. Tweak vs. Leo is a matchup as old as time, and in classic Ultimate fashion, Tweak is having a character crisis again! Yeah! And yet again, Tweak gets up to 2-0 against Leo. Can you guess what happens next? Yup, I can't believe it either! This shit is scripted! Leo has finally fought his way into Grand Finals, where his final match would be against... Oh no. This is Meister. He's a great player, easily top 5 in the world, homie wipes the floor with nearly everyone in bracket. However, Meister's current offline record against Leo is 0-13. He has literally never taken a set off Leo. The next 23 minutes would result in one of the worst ass whoopings in Ultimate history. 6-0, and he switched to Byleth Game 6 for the BM. So, just like that, despite every roadblock in the way, Leo did it. A lot of people are calling Light's recent run at SmashCon the best Ultimate run ever, and while it was a roller coaster to watch, Leo's run still completely outclasses it. After dropping to losers in top 96, Leo beat PGR ranked number 2, number 3, number 4, number 6 twice, 7, number 9, 12, 22, and number 30. With three of those sets going to Game 5 and Top 8. Here's another statistic. The last time Leo placed outside the top 2 in an offline event was in May of 2019. That's 15 major or regional placements in a row! Since Frostbite and the pandemic, Leo's continued to dominate the competition. With placements at Summit 3, Riptide, Glitch 8.5, and LTC, he's still the king of Ultimate despite changing mains.
That's why he's the GOAT! The GOAT!
Hi everyone, I am painfully aware of how overdue this video is, but I swear I have a good excuse. Since my Overwatch video, I have scripted and edited 2 full videos only to have them scrapped last minute, so I've been a little busy. One of those videos I'm dropping entirely, but the other was a Shang-Chi review I decided not to upload, so if you guys want to see that one, let me know in the comments. I still have a lot of good video ideas, some of which are already written and recorded, so like and subscribe just to keep up with me.
You can hit the bell if you would.
I really appreciate all the support I get on these videos. Thank you guys so much, and thank you all for watching. see you next time.